Now, I come to the ethical reasons. There are many ethical reasons not to have dairy and meat. First of all, when we have such healthy alternatives like grains, fruits, vegetables, for all our nutrient needs, why would we opt for something that causes so much pain and suffering to animals? There is no reason for that. The meat and cattle industry is a business, and the cattle and the birds are their commodities, are their raw material. So, like any business, they have to use the best and the cheapest means to produce their material, which is milk and meat. So their business practices are more on a business, good for their business, but may not necessarily be good for the consumers. For example, cows, the milking cows, they are given high doses of growth hormones so that they can continue to give milk and high yield of milk. Sometimes they give 10 times what their normal capacity would be just because of the growth hormones. They are kept pregnant throughout their lifespan so that they continue to lactate. And they are milked all the time so they get a lot of these diseases like mastitis, the disease of the udders, which is very, very painful. And when they have female calves, they are brought into the stock where they will replace the older cows. But what happens to the male calves? They are sent to the wheel crates, which are these dark, compact crates without any light. They are put in there and fed liquid iron deficient diet so that they get anemic, and their meat is considered a delicacy, I would assume, because it's very lean, it's not fat, not much fat, it's lean and it's white in color, and they are killed at 3 months. So these practices along, now because the cows are milked for their whole lifespan, their bones get brittle because of the, so much of leaching of the calcium in their bodies. So they suffer a lot from broken bones, which obviously, you cannot tell. It's not easy to understand their suffering. And their lifespan also, because of all this stress, their lifespan is also, like a normal cow's lifespan is about 20 to 25 years, but these cows, they only survive from 4 to 5 years. There's so much intense stress on their bodies. And once they cannot produce any more milk, they are sent to slaughter. So the meat that comes out of these cows is full, again, it's not healthy in that way. It is like a cow which is really sick. Obviously, that's why it's being sent to slaughter, and that goes into our foods. Huh? The next is chickens. The egg farm, the chicks in the egg farm, they are kept in such small, compact areas that the chickens get very aggressive because this is not their environment. They are not used to the lack of freedom to move around. And so they get very aggressive. They start attacking each other. And to prevent that, their beaks are cut off and their claws are removed so that they cannot attack each other. And they're kept under constant light because that would help them to grow faster. And in the egg farming, what do they do with the male chicks? There is the male chicks, if they are not used for breeding, they are of no use. So the best option for these industries is to kill the male chicks. And the cheapest way is to either drown them or to put them in this grinder. Most of the time they are put alive in the grinder, and the grinder creates feed for the other chickens. Life, so they are fed their own own, yeah. So another thing is, another ethical factor is world hunger. It has been found that a lot of land and water resources are being used just for farming, agricultural farming, to create feed for the life, for the cattle stock. More and more land that could be used to grow grains and plants and fruits for human consumption is being used to feed the cattle, which the yield from which is much, much less, and it serves only a small population of the world. Most of the population is going hungry. It's said that 20 vegetarians can be fed on the same piece of land which would give feed to create meat for one person. So the utilization of land and water resources is absolutely lopsided. It is also said that the amount of grains and soybeans that's produced in the U.S. to feed the livestock could feed the whole world, of the whole starving population of the world. It's at that level. And now the environmental reasons. Some of them I've already mentioned, is that, you know, the water resources and the land resources. There's large-scale deforestation just to create more land to grow livestock feed. Then water is being also, groundwater is also being used for that. There's a lot of pressure on our resources because of that. There is a lot of wastage from the cattle industry, which is going into our land, and along with all the growth hormones, the antibiotics, the waste from the manure, everything is leaching into the land and into the water. Besides that, there's the effect on the biodiversity. Most of these livestock farming, when they create feed for the livestock, they are doing a single crop agriculture. They're just growing soybeans or they're growing corn because that's what they need. They are going from diverse, multiple crop farming, they're going into single crop farming, and that is killing the diversity of our land. Now the other side effect of this industry, of the meat and dairy industry, is the marketing, the transportation. That itself is creating a lot of other side environmental impact. It seems 18% of the greenhouse gas emission comes from this industry. And this is not even counting the peripheral industries that are operating around the meat and dairy. The packaging industry, the transport, the processing, the factories. Now, so it looks like there's only one simple solution to this problem, and that is going vegan, because it solves your health problems. There are so many chronic diseases that one can prevent. Then there's the health reasons, and then there's the environmental reasons. Both of these can be solved by going vegan. Now, Ayurvedic and vegan food, when you bring the two concepts together, it gives us a lot of variety of ingredients. We have fruits, vegetables, nuts, grains, and seeds, and these are really complete to give us all the nourishment and all the nutrients we need. The good advantage of an Indian diet is that it's already quite balanced, and although it uses a lot of dairy, Ayurvedic, especially Ayurvedic diet, is highly dependent on dairy, on ghee, milk, yogurt, in its diet. But it is also very easy to incorporate vegan concepts into Ayurveda. I have found that it is the easiest to create a balanced meal of chapati, rice, dal, and a little bit of salad, and it's vegan. There are so many Indian dishes which are already